You're a good soldier, choosing your battles. Pick yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over. The pressure's on, you feel it. This is Africa. Tamina, mina, eh, eh. Waka, waka, eh, eh. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. This time for Africa. Listen to your dad. This is our motto. Your time to shine. Don't wait in line.
When you're tasting wine, you tend to look at the spectrum of wines you're tasting on a flavor portfolio. So for instance, Shiraz will give you a lot of black pepper. Now if you had that first, it will overpower the cherries and the berries from the Merlot. So that's the only reason. But in my opinion, this is probably one of the best Merlots I've tasted in many years. It's incredibly dark in color for a Merlot. We just get it naturally. There's just amazingly good color in the Merlot. And it's a wine that's not the traditional, plain, minty Merlot. But it's got these undertoning layers of wet leather and sort of almost...
Just when you said that, it was right there.
Wet leather and sort of the... When you walk into a museum, you get that old shelf flavor.
Okay.
The smells leather, of yeah. Dustiness.
Leather comes.
Once again, this is a 2006, so we bottled in 2008, and have been, after we bottle it, it'll stay unlabeled underground for 3 years. So by the time it's released to the market, it's 5 years from making, it should be nice, the tenants are around, and it's a principle we have, which economically, if you ask winemakers, is not supposed to work, but for us it works because we have boutique cellar, we can afford to do that. But in a commercial cellar, it just doesn't, it's not feasible to have five vintages in your cellar the whole time. So we're very lucky to.
We could even look at doing a vertical tasting if you want.
Yes. We have quite a nice library, a collection of wine, and we can do a vertical tasting.
Yeah. Our wine club members enjoy getting the years.
When we're getting close to the 300 years, so by next year for the build-up for 2050, I'm going to release a vertical batch. We'll have a 5-box Merlot, 5-box Cab, 5-box Syrah, with 5 different years in
one.
We'll do 300 of those cases. So that will be obviously first come, first serve type of thing, but it'll be a numbered, we'll put a special label on and label it as part of the collection now.
The common thread here is the smoothness, eh? To me.
It's and that's those extra 3 years where the bottles are stored in cages makes a big difference. Because it gives time for the wine to naturally age a little bit.
Yes.
Rather than bottling it, putting in the market now, the guy is drinking this wine, he thinks, I'm not that impressed. But he doesn't have the knowledge to cellar it for the right amount of time. So we take the thinking over one little bit by cellaring it ourselves for 3 years. And then by the time the client gets it, there's no thinking about it. You open it up, you enjoy it. We can even cellar this for another 5 to 8 years.